In this video, I'll briefly introduce you to queries in NVivo. You can think of queries as questions that you might ask NVivo of your data, your coding, and your metadata. You can find queries are available under the Explore ribbon, where you can see there's a query wizard which will guide you through a text search, word frequency, coding query, or matrix query. You can also manually create a text search query, word frequency query, or matrix coding query using the buttons on the ribbon. To access the rest of the queries, you'll need to click on the queries drop-down, and here you can find the coding, crosstab, coding comparison, compound, and group queries. If you use the query wizard, it will guide you through. For example, let's look at a text search query where we're looking to see where a particular term occurs in context. We can enter the term that we're going to search for. I've chosen the word fish, and then we can click next. It also gives us the option to limit this query to just particular source files. So I could search in all of the files or just selected items or folders. In this case, I'm just going to have a look at the folder containing the interviews. Once ticked, I can click OK and then click Next. I have the option to run this query just once or save the query criteria so I can access it again. I'm just going to call this Text Search Fish. I'm now ready to run the query. We won't look at this in detail right now, as the next video will look at the text search query in a lot of detail. However, you'll remember that I saved this query criteria. Any query criteria that you save can be found under Explore in the Queries folder, and then Query Criteria. If we look at the example project that ships with NVivo, you'll see there's a whole variety of different examples of queries, from coding comparison to crosstabs. These queries are a really good place for you to learn much more about queries and how they work, and we can see the text search fish query that I just run is available here. Over the course of the next few videos, we'll look at some of these queries in a lot more detail, and show how you can get lots of real rich insights into your data with queries.